Okay, well, welcome to another interesting section of the Teach Yourself QuickBooks. Now, in this section, we are going to be talking about something very, very important, something every business is mandated to do, and it's actually legal. It's something that the law requires you to do. What is that? That is VAT. Now, we're going to be discussing VAT. You know, when we're doing our company setup, I already explained how to set up your VAT. So that when you create invoice or when you create a sales receipt, you can always deduct your 5% and keep it. Now, whenever you deduct those amounts, they are actually going to an account, which is called your VAT payable account. Now, that VAT payable account lets you to track all the amounts that you have deducted as VAT from your sales, which is supposed to be remitted to your tax authority. Now, to confirm that, when you go to your list here, you go to chart of accounts and trace the account to track that VAT. So if you come here, you see VAT here, you see VAT payable. You can see our VAT payable so far is 79,240, which is the amount we're supposed to pay tax authority here. So now, to file your VAT, which is another important thing, at the point of settling your VAT, paying tax authority, you need to also be able to reconcile whatever you are paying to them to what the system is telling you, so that you don't have a different figure here in QuickBooks and also be remitting a different figure to your tax authority. Now, to confirm your VAT, you go to your VAT here, you click VAT summary reports. Now, this VAT summary report shows you the amount you're supposed to pay as VAT. Now, under the VAT agency, you select FRS Nigeria. Now, you can see the amount here. You come here, you click all. So you can see the same amount, 77,950, which is our VAT. If you have been tracking VAT on purchases, which is VAT input, it will appear here. But I want to explain a very simple thing, a very simple term. A simple step you can use to remit your VAT and also account for your VAT input. Probably if you track VAT on purchases and you have VAT input, which is always deducted from your VAT output, I will explain how to do that in the system effectively. Now, let's assume now that we've made a sale of 1.5, which is this, and this is what we're supposed to remit to tax authority. But from our record, we realize that we have been paying VAT input on purchases, but we've not been tracking it in the system, and we're supposed to record it in the system too. Now, what we need to do is we need to also create an account called adjustment, which we use to adjust this figure. Now, assuming that 70,000 out of this particular amount is what we have paid supplier so far as VAT, and we have our receipts to account for that, which means we're supposed to pay 7,950 as VAT to the government after keeping the 70,000. How do we now enter that into the system? Now, when you go to your VAT summary report here, you click File VAT Return. When you click File, if you don't want to click File VAT Return, you can always go to your VAT and click File VAT Return. They are almost the same thing here. But why I like going through this process is that with this particular way, you can always view your VAT payable on a monthly basis, or you can always see from which month and which month. Like here, you can see from which month to which month. So with this, you need to change your VAT to a particular month, and the system will show it up. Now, let's assume we want to pay this particular amount. We want to file it and pay to the tax authority. If you look at your VAT here, you confirm, this is what I have actually deducted as VAT on sales, but I have 70,000 to deduct from this amount, which is what I've also paid to my supplier. That is amount to be claimed. You click File VAT Return. When you click File VAT Return, it takes you to this angle. Now, you know, I said initially that we're supposed to pay 7,950 after deducting 70,000. So what you need to do now is you click Adjust Return. When you click Adjust Return, this is what you use to adjust this amount here. Now, the VAT item you want to adjust is VAT on sales. You select VAT on sales. Now, the adjustment account, if you look at this, it's not here, which means we need to add an adjustment account to this. So you come down here, you click New. Now, that adjustment account is money coming back to your business and all that. So you now come here, you put VAT adjustment here, or you can probably call it VAT reclaim, VAT reclaim and all that, which is your VAT here. So it's your money, so you have to reclaim it back from tax authority here. So it's an income to you because you are removing it from what you're supposed to pay and all that. So here you click save and close. So an account to track that is 70,000. So what is now the amount? If the amount is 70,000, you come here, you enter 70,000 naira here. And also be mindful of this amount, we are going to reduce it, we're not increasing it. So you come here, decrease VAT line. So remember, it's VAT adjustment. So what that means is that this 70,000 will be deducted from this amount, then the remaining balance is what we are going to pay. What that means is that we have deducted 77,000 naira from the sales we made based on VAT. Then we have also paid. So if you have collected more than you have paid, the difference is what you will remit. If you have collected less than what you have paid, you're not supposed to remit anything. Besides, the balance will be carried over to the next period. So when you enter this, you click OK. Now see what happened. It has reduced here. So it has reduced here, meaning that we are not paying that 77,000 again, we are paying 7,009. So you come here, you click refresh return, then you can click file your return, then you click assign. No. So you can see an account to track that is account payable because we want to pay it now. So you come here, you click OK. So okay, you can see congratulations, you have finished processing your VAT return in QuickBooks. Then you click OK here. So you can see the amounts now is showing here. So you come here, you click this balance. So we are paying 7,950. So you click on this section here, then you click 7,950, which is the actual amount we are paying to FRS. Then from which bank, we select the Naira account, GTB. Then which, how are we paying it? We're paying it by cash. Then you select the date. Then you can see here now, FRS Nigeria and all that. Then you click pay selected bill. So with this, we've been able to pay our VAT. So when you come here, you click done here. So if you come down to VAT, you go to file return, then you select your FRS here and click FRS this VAT here. You can see that it's showing zero. You can see that we no longer have any VAT to pay. We finish paying everything after deducting VAT input and all that. So whenever you want to pay your VAT, it's also important that you also track all the amounts you have paid to your supplier, so that will form what we call VAT reclaim, which will be deducted from what you have collected from your supplier, sorry, from your customer. Then it is the remaining balance that will be remitted to tax authority and all that. So it's very important for you to be able to do that. That's the essence of doing your VAT and QuickBooks and all that. Like here you can see these are details of all the VATs that you have collected based on the sales that we have made. You can see VAT on sales. You can see these are reports showing all our VAT and all that. You can see, so it's very important for you to be able to run this report in QuickBooks to understand what you're supposed to pay as VAT, and you can also see on which sales am I supposed to pay this VAT on and all that. So if there are some VAT that are exempted from, if some sales that are exempted from the VAT, that means at the point of placing your invoice, you don't need to select that VAT code, just leave it like that, or select VAT exempt. So if you have any question on VAT or filing your VAT return and all that, you can also send a mail to info@accountingsoftware.com.ng.